Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Will the ASL students please join us on stage for the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the Star Spangled Banner.
Oh,
Foster. I'm a senior class officer, and today I will be delivering the invitation prayer. So if you would please bow your heads, close your eyes, and pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this beautiful day and for allowing us to gather within our circumstances. Thank you for allowing us the opportunity to finish our last year of high school in person and giving us the blessing of a memorable senior year. We thank you for encouraging families, teachers, staff, coaches, and other role models who helped us prepare for today and along our journey throughout these four unpredictable years. Thank you, Lord, for the relationships we have gained along the way, lessons, and challenges we have faced throughout our high school career. Lord, I ask you to guide us in our upcoming chapters in life and direct us towards a successful future in whatever that may be. God bless us as we advance into an unknown period in our lives with new people, new experiences, and new places. I pray we walk this fresh journey with love, faith, and hope. Thank you for this time, and may you protect us today and in our future. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you.
Principal of 206 students who sit before you at today's commencement ceremony. On behalf of the Buckeye Board of Education, our superintendent, the administrative team, our faculty and staff, I would like to welcome you to the commencement services of Buckeye High School's class of 2021. I would also like to extend a special thank you to the Medina City Schools for their generosity in allowing us to use this great facility. We were able to have such a nice event because the Medina Schools, the Medina County Career Center, and Buckeye Local Schools came together as one to make this a special night. I would like to take this time to introduce our Board of Education, the Central Office of Administration, and at this time, as I call your name, I'm asking you to please stand. President, Mrs. Denise Pavarchi. Vice President, Mr. Ken Barco. Member, Mrs. Barb Gunkelman. Member, Mr. Rob Banaga. Member, Mr. John Stahl. The Central Office of Administration, Superintendent, Mr. Jeff Harrison. Treasurer, Mrs. Jennifer Knapp. Director of Curriculum, Mrs. Bridget Elias. Assistant Principal, Mr. Adam Snook. Athletic Director, Tom Harrington. School Counselor, Mrs. Amanda Hogue. School Counselor, Mrs. Jennifer Wish. Superintendent of Medina County Career Center, Mr. Steve Christmas. Principal of Medina County Career Center, Mrs. Teresa Goodwin. Representing the Medina County ESC, Mrs. Rachel Krause. Director of Special Education, Mr. Brendan Zepp. Junior High Principal, Mrs. Shannon Conley Kurgeon. Intermediate Principal, Mrs. Kelly Davidson. And Primary Principal, Mrs. Dawn Kashanik. At this time, I would also like to have all faculty members of Buckeye Local Schools stand and be applauded. At this time, I'd like to bring up our superintendent, Mr. Jeffrey Harrison.
Thank you, Mr. Flood. Good evening, and thanks for your attendance this evening. As Mr. Flood spoke, I would also like to thank Medina City Schools for their generosity in opening this facility to us, because last night, tonight, and tomorrow afternoon, the students of the Career Center, Buckeye High School, Medina High School will walk across this very same stage. It's just yet another example of the teamwork in Medina County. It is not common across the state to have a county of school districts that work as closely as Medina County for the betterment of our students, and they greatly benefit. What a year. I have to admit, during the first weeks of school, I did not know if we'd be here this evening. For so very long, we simply took events like graduation for granted. It is the rite of passage. It just happens every spring, right? Well, if we've learned anything over the year, we will no longer take life for granted. The first day of school, I was driving west on Spieth Road on the way in. And for the very first time in months, since the March prior, there were students standing at the end of their drive with their families waiting for the school bus. Something that we have taken for granted year after year after year. But this time was different. I have to admit it was slightly emotional to see the students and families so excited about coming back to school. And here in Buckeye, we were extremely lucky with the support of the community and our faculty and staff to be in person for learning, because we knew that was best. Thank you for your continued support of our fine students sitting here today. As a first-year superintendent coming to a new district, I had no idea what the next day was going to bring during a worldwide pandemic. But I have to extend my gratitude to the Board of Education, who stood strong and supported their community to make sure that our students were in person, even when districts around us chose not to be in person. The faculty and staff that continue to display the unwavering commitment to in-person learning, because deep down they knew that our students needed us, but realistically, we needed them. To our community, for showing as new superintendent forgiveness, flexibility, and grace. We lived Thursday to Thursday waiting for that all call. Would we be in person or would we be going virtual? But most importantly, thank you, seniors. Your leadership within the walls of Buckeye High School is what made this a successful year. You attacked every day with enthusiasm and passion. No longer would you take for granted some of the high school traditions that the classes before you enjoyed. Looking back at this year, there were a few times that stood out in my mind about how special of a class you were. The first was the first home Friday night football game. Tickets were scarce. Not many people were allowed in, but that wasn't going to stop you. As the game began and the kickoff happened, I watched student after student stand along the guardrail to see over the fence. You cheered, you yelled, you screamed, you showed your Buckeye passion. You even cried. And I thought to myself, this is a special place with special students. They weren't going to let something like a worldwide pandemic stop them from enjoying the traditions of their high school, and especially senior year. The other example was this spring, being a baseball guy myself. I took advantage of the beautiful weather to walk out to see a baseball scrimmage. And as I walked to the field, I saw this mass of students on the hill. In my head, I'm thinking, are they socially distant? Are they wearing masks? But they were having a blast. And they had one lone drum that they continued to beat and show their Buckeye pride. I kind of felt bad for Evan, who was playing left field for the visiting team. As I sat there as a superintendent, I thought, should I really tell our students to cheer for our team and leave poor Evan alone? But I found it hard to stop the enthusiasm and pride that our students were showing. They were somewhat appropriate, typical teenagers cheering on the visiting team. But what was unique was when the center fielder yelled to the right fielder. He says, they have a student section for a baseball game. And the right fielder says, I wish our students would do something like that. Yet another example how the students of Buckeye are so very special. When I was coming to Buckeye and being welcomed to the district, time in and time again, I was told how wonderful the students are. Seniors, you made that true. You're beyond special. You have persevered in a year where you could have wallowed in your pity, but you chose not to. You showed determination, grit, perseverance. I leave you with one simple quote. Life is not determined by what happens to you, but rather how you react to what happens to you. And as you leave the halls of Buckeye High School and on to the next stage of your career, if you can attack those moments with the enthusiasm and passion that you attack this school year, you'll be successful and you will make us proud as Buckeye alum. Class of 2021, I couldn't be more proud of you, and thank you for leading our school in one of the most difficult years in recent history. Thank you.
Thank you to the parents, grandparents, teachers, coaches, and any other family member or friends that have helped influence a student in the graduating class of 2021. I consider myself very lucky to have been involved in their lives. The class of 2021 has many academic scholars, outstanding athletes, great musicians, and artists. As a class and as individuals, you may be remembered for some of these accolades, but more importantly, you'll be remembered for some of the characteristics you have developed along the way. You will be remembered for who you are as a person and not so much about what you've accomplished or achieved. Many of you have heard the speech that Coach Jim Valvano gave prior to his passing. Coach Valvano spoke about doing three things every single day. He said, if you laugh, you think, and you cry, you'll live a complete day. Well, you guys are special. My goal isn't for you to live just one complete day. It's to live a complete life. After everything that we've dealt with over this past year, it's hard for me not to fathom laughing, thinking, or crying without people in our lives. You will not be able to do anything extraordinary if you don't have close relationships with people. Throughout your elementary, junior high, and high school years, you've been lucky to build close relationships with some of your best friends. As you enter into the next journey of your life, you will meet new lifelong friends. You might meet your future husband or wife, or your future employer. People are everything in our lives. Doesn't matter how talented or how smart you are if you don't have someone to share those moments with. At this time, I'd like to bring up my assistant, Mr. Adam Snook.
The class of 2021 has had a high standard of academic achievement. This year is the second year in which Buckeye High School is honoring our top achieving students within the cum laude system. As our students are presented to you today, we will make mention of those honors. The class of 2021 has a total of 63 students who have achieved these top academic honors. Summa cum laude are students who have achieved a 4.4 GPA or higher. This class has 16 of them. magna cum laude, which is a 4.0 to a 4.39 GPA. This class has 25 of them. And cum laude is a GPA ranging from a 3.7 to a 3.99. This class has 22 of them. At this time, I would like to recognize the top scholars of the class of 2021. Graduates, if you are graduating with summa cum laude honors, please stand and remain standing to be recognized. If you are graduating with magna cum laude honors, please stand to be recognized. If you are graduating with cum laude honors, please stand to be recognized. I would also ask that the following groups also stand to be recognized. First, those graduates wearing honors cords, please raise to be recognized. Those who have non-academic honors, FFA, NHS, JOGS, and athletics, please stand to be recognized. Those students who have earned an honors diploma, President's Award for Educational Excellence, Scholastic Awards, Artistic Awards, or Athletic Awards, please rise. Finally, may I please have any graduate entering the military or armed forces, please rise. As you can see, this class has earned numerous awards and honors in leadership, philanthropy, and academic accomplishments. I am confident they will continue to reach the highest levels of achievement in all of their future endeavors. On behalf of the faculty and staff at Buckeye High School, we want to offer our congratulations and best of luck to the class of 2021. Please help me in introducing Buckeye High School Upbeat Group, as they will now perform Sing.
Thanks, Mom.
Thanks.
Hello. Oh. Music awakens memories of forgotten times. It allows us to recall happy moments with family and friends. It has the incredible power to help us go beyond our own barriers and explore new possibilities. As you move on to this new chapter in your life, with all of its ups and many downs, remember the healing power of music. Never be afraid to sing.
Sing! It doesn't matter if your days are long.
Sing!
It doesn't matter if your night's gone wrong.
Sing!
Just clap your hands and stomp your feet.
And sing it, whoa, oh, oh.
Sing!
It doesn't matter if he let you go.
Sing!
She hurt you so.
Sing. Just clap your hands and stomp your feet
and sing it. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't know why you've been so, but music make you lose control. Sing, 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 sing it out as loud as you can. Make them hear you from a later Japan. Don't let them bring you down. This is how we do it now. Going home.
It doesn't matter if you're way off track.
Sing!
Feel like you're headed for a heart attack.
Sing!
Just raise your voice
and bring the noise and sing it. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Sing!
Sing for your mama.
Sing!
Sing for your daughter.
Sing!
Sing for your sisters, mister, best friends, brother, cuz. I don't know what you've been told, but music make you lose control. Sing, 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 sing. Sing it out as loud as you can. Make a
your mama, ay. Sing it for your papa, ay. Sing it for the whole world. Boy, boy, girl, for your number one fan. KO to the beat, okay? I'm the human 808. Go ahead, go sing it, don't talk, cause the beat won't stop. No, wait, 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 wait.
Sing, 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 sing. Sing it out as loud as you can. Make them hear you from LA to Japan. Don't let them bring you down. This is how we do it now. Going home and windows down. Sing, 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 sing. Sing it with your hands in the sky. Light it up like it's the 4th of July. Don't let them bring you down. You know what I'm talking about. A little bit louder now.
It is an incredible honor to introduce Buckeye High School's Class of 2021 valedictorian and salutatorian. This year's salutatorian is Julia Grady. Julia has earned an impressive 4.822 cumulative GPA. Julia will be attending Baldwin-Wallace University for viola performance and music composition. It is my pleasure to introduce to you salutatorian Julia Grady.
Hello, everyone. I have been in this school for 13 years. 13 years since kindergarten with Mrs. Luth. So now we're here at graduation, and I'm making a speech. And I think it's fitting that it's Friday, because as musical kids know, it is No Filter Friday. So 13 years, now graduation. And during that time, because I'm standing up here, you can probably tell that I have been absolutely focused on academics the entire time. However, especially in the last 4 years, there have been some things that are getting comparatively more and more important to me. I'm sure we can all recall times with our friends, with our classmates. Maybe you met someone sophomore year and you're attached at the hip now, convinced you must have known each other your entire life. Or maybe a friend moved away and you're both atrocious at communication, but somehow you're staying in touch. Or maybe a friend found himself sometime in the last year, and you couldn't be more proud. I've also, as has been mentioned, done a lot of music, but considering I am going to college for that, I think no further explanation is really necessary or needed. I've also, in the past 4 years of high school, done a lot of advocacy work, and it has been one of the most rewarding experiences that I have had. I am the co-founder and co-president of the Genders and Sexualities Alliance, or GSA, a founding member of the Diversity Union, and a member of that union's smaller outreach group. Through these groups, I have been able to meet some of the most wonderful people. People who are, to put it simply, but also a bit cliche, focused on making the world a better place. Determined to have the school and this community be the most supporting and beautifully accepting as possible. And I will be forever grateful that I was able to be a step in this journey to that as it blossoms. I cannot wait to see how the groups take it from here. I have to say, though, without the support of the counselors the entire way, GSA might not have happened. As soon as in late junior year I proposed the idea to them, they were on board. They were looking up resources, talking to organizations, whatever had to be done to make this group happen, to make this safe space happen, and to support that supportive environment at our school. And to the counselors, thank you for the care that you have shown me, whether that's in academics with GSA or anything else. And thank you for the care that you have shown every single one of your students over the years that has passed into your care. To Mr. Call, I cannot tell you how much I enjoy hearing viola throughout the halls, although I do not entirely know how to respond to that still. I fully expect that when I come back for VITS, I will still hear that. To Ms. Repus, AP Environmental was one of my favorite classes. I had taken a very similar course prior, but I still learned so much. So thank you for a wonderful class and being an even more wonderful teacher. To Ms. Cuddy, Lit and Lang were also two of my favorite classes, and I have gotten so much support from you over these last 2 years that I've known you. So thank you for that support, for two awesome classes, and for the letter of recommendation. To Mr. Z, you have had me in I don't even know how many classes now, counting high school and junior high. So thank you for your help, whether it comes to project ideas, techniques, or the supplies that I will get back to you within the week. There are so many others that I wish I could thank individually, everyone from elementary school, really. But we would be here forever if I did that. So thank you to all of the teachers who have genuinely supported me throughout the years, to the office people who have let me in a perplexing number of times per day this past year, and to anyone else, like the custodians who kept our school clean and ready to learn in. And thank you to my family for supporting my endeavors, my friends for being awesome, as always. And thank you to the graduating class of 2021. Though we may now be going in every manner of future plans and actual geographic location, for the support and for the memories that I will never forget. Thank you.
Thank you, Julia. It is now my privilege to introduce Anga Lau, the class of 2021's valedictorian. Anga has earned an impressive 4.851 cumulative GPA. Anga will be heading to the United States Naval Academy and has not yet declared her major.
Hello?
I'm short. Sorry. Hi, everybody. Hi, class of 2021. It's been really weird how a year can pass by so excruciatingly slow, yet so fast at the same time. We're halfway into 2021, 10 days until June, but I still feel like 2021 has just been like an extension of 2020. Sucks to be in a pandemic, I guess. I'm sure everybody's tired of hearing about the pandemic by now, but to be quite honest, I think that Buckeye handled the pandemic situation quite well. We as students and families got the opportunity to choose to go back to school or stay at home based on what was most comfortable and convenient for us, And flexibility is a key trait in success. Even though the school did their part, it obviously doesn't mean everyone didn't face hard times. I think I can speak for a lot of us when I say that the fall of last year was a hot mess. A sense of direction, I don't know her. I dove headfirst into honors courses, never really knowing what I was even learning on my own. And college applications seemed to ask a never-ending list of questions. If you're normal, unlike me, you probably did not procrastinate and freak out until the last minute to scramble and get everything together, like I did. I turned in one of my college applications 2 days before the deadline. But I guess luck was with me this year because, well, with college admissions at least, apparently all my applications landed me an offer. Outside my success, I had a constant internal struggle against what? Most people may be facing serious situations, such as losing a loved one, a frayed relationship, or depression, anxiety, handling all their schoolwork. And my heart really goes out to all of those who may be facing all of those situations this year. Again, what was my internal struggle? Lazy. I wanted to give up all the time. I thought being able to stay at home and do whatever I wanted would be a dream. But being by myself, that made me have to face myself. I had to face the consequences of every loss of control over my time and every loss of control over my decisions. What I thought was limiting me was actually what gave me structure. And the rigidity of a school schedule did exactly that. It kept me on track to reach my goals, my assignments, every time that I had to study. That's what the school schedule did for me. And for somebody like me, that struggles all the time finding internal motivation, controlling my own schedule was extremely difficult. This speech isn't a success story I'm telling you filled with my accomplishments. I don't want this to sound like I'm standing on a high mountain and giving you advice. All of you people are probably all older than me. I still barely know how to organize my days and my schedule. And my schedule right now is non-existent. All I do is stay at home and nap and watch Netflix. I don't know where I want to be 20 years down the road. The answer to that is just something that I made up to sound smart to interviewers. I just happened to be somebody who got the opportunity to stand up here and share what my journey was like and some of my perspectives. So here's a reminder to everyone and myself. Nobody's future is guaranteed. I'm not going to stand up here and tell every one of you guys, our future is bright. We have a promised future, because it's not. Every one of the decisions that we make now leads up to who we will be in the future. I just said I'm not here to give advice, but I would like to recommend a tip. Every day or every time that you stray off your path, imagine yourself as a very old person. Just an old version of yourself, okay? For me, she looks like this. So, again, when you find yourself straying off your path, you have to imagine this older version of yourself. Is the older version of yourself enjoying sun on a cruise and straight up vibing? Or are they regretting every decision that they've made in their lives? It's a weird way to keep myself on track to attain my goals, but me as a very old lady is very menacing when she comes to visit and scold me about not reaching my goals when I could have. It's not about punishing yourself, but to think about and consider all the decisions that you make now is something that you're happy with now, but also in the future. And, you know, do whatever to keep yourself on track. And if it's imagining some old lady coming to you and whacking you on the forehead with her cane, so be it. Find your own way to pursue the goals that you want. Not everyone can follow the general advice of chase your dreams and expect it to work out in every situation. Because everybody's different. We come from different things or situations are different. So find the thing that works for you. People close to you can help you, and please seek help when you can. I really wouldn't be here today without my family's support, my mom's constant nagging to do good, my little sister for always cheering me up, my stepdad there to give me every advice, and my grandma for just being my sweet grandma. I would like to thank Ms. Wish's guidance. Senor Drip's time in helping me improve my Espanol. Every teacher that ever had that's made a positive impact in my life, and my friends for solid advice all the time. Well, most of the time. You can help, or you can and should get help from people who care about you because they want to see you succeed. But ultimately, your future is yours. So go ahead and enjoy life. Make it yours, but in the end, be happy with all your decisions. Thank you.
Thank you, Julia. Thank you, Anga. And once again, congratulations on your outstanding academic achievements. At this time, I ask Alyssa Healy and Capri Thomas, please come to the stage to introduce this year's speaker.
Good evening. We stand before you today to introduce our staff speaker. He is known for teaching probably the worst subject ever, math. Some of the classes he teaches are Algebra 2, Pre-Calculus, and Analysis.
He has taught at Buckeye for 12 years, and in those years he has coached junior high football, junior high basketball, and recently became a National Honor Society advisor. But most importantly, he makes the best cafeteria monitor. Despite never having him as a teacher myself, my personal experience involved earning the nickname Juice Box within the first week of freshman year. He was more than willing to help me understand any math-related problem, even if he didn't teach the class. Personally, he has helped me to develop into who I am today. During my high school career, I only had him for 1 year of actual class, but every day he made fun of me, and I mean every day. I wouldn't trade these short moments for anything else. He has also always been there for me, not only in the classroom, but also with personal advice in my own life. If there was ever something I needed to talk about, he was the person I went to. He is a teacher that I will always think of when someone brings up high school. He is the person that could make you laugh and cry in one day. He is a role model to me and many others.
He's allergic to red dye.
He hates getting his picture taken.
He's Mr. Harris's twin.
And he is the biggest Browns fan.
So please give a warm welcome
to the one and only Mr. Cease.
That Brown stinks a lie, so I just want to start with that. I'll be honest with you, I wasn't going to add this part, but I haven't been this nervous to get the talk in front of people. It's not honestly because of you, it's because my mom and wife are watching right now, so I can't mess up. So before I begin, I want to thank everyone who's made tonight possible. There are so many people that made tonight possible for you to be sitting here. That ranges from Buckeye's administration and staff, to Medina schools and their staff, all your family members, even all of you doing what you needed to do so this could happen. But I want to focus on two individuals specifically. The first one is Mrs. George, and the second one is Mrs. Hogue. Because those two, in case you did not know, this didn't happen overnight. This wasn't last week. They've been working for you for months to make sure you could have this day. So I just want to say on behalf of you, for thank you. So now let's begin. Congratulations, class of 2021. You did it. You're even on time. I don't think in the 4 years of high school, all of you made it on time anywhere. So great job. I want to introduce myself for those of you that do not know who I am. My name is George Michael Cease, but I go by Mike or Michael. So let's get the questions that most of you parents have out of the way quickly. One, I was named after my father, not the lead singer of Wham. And two, yes, I do have faith. For those of you who are still lost, just Google it. This is the second time I've given a speech at graduation, and I'm deeply honored to be considered for this. I also respect the ability to call my bluff, because I've said the only way to ever attend graduation is if you ask me to speak. Well, it took 9 years the first time, and then you guys did it within three, so nice job. I bet you're all wondering why this 35-year-old math teacher was picked. Could it be because I still look like a high school student? Maybe. Maybe it's because, according to my wife, I still act like a high school student. I personally thought it's because I lost a bet to someone and you guys made me do this. So, but if you want the honest answer, it was because the senior class voted for me, and I got the majority of the votes, all 12 of them. I was wondering why they selected me over so many great teachers and counselors to choose from, like the great Mr. Luther, or the great counselor that is Miss Hogue or Miss Wish. And then I started thinking, did I have many interactions with you? Like, you all know me and I don't know you, but then I went back and looked, and out of the 206 of you, over the last 6 years, I taught or coached 150 of you. So I'd say I'm about as good as an expert as there can be amongst Buckeye staff. I've watched you all grow from these small, awkward junior high kids to young adults that are a little less small and a little less awkward. I was asked over the last several weeks what I was going to say and if I started writing. Every single time, I give the same answer. Nope. I just didn't know where to start. Most graduation speeches come with a theme or a big idea. Common themes include, but are not limited to, bravery, face your fears, or my personal favorite, overcome adversity. The more I thought about it, the more it became clear why I couldn't get a theme or an idea. If you all think back to the start of the school year, it was extremely scary for everyone, not just you, not just your parents, but it was absolutely terrifying for us teachers. Every school district, and Buckeye was no exception, was trying to give you the safest, healthiest school environment we could. Policies seemed to change every day, and it felt like threat level purple was the next day. Policies changed left and right, daily lesson plans, daily meetings, everything trying to follow proper protocol. And even though we were freaking out, and it took us a while to get the hang of it, you all brought a positive attitude. You followed directions to the best of your abilities. You rolled with policies. And if it wasn't for you, we would not be sitting here. So thank you for that. As I thought about the school year and started to think about where we are now, that's when I realized everything that could be used for graduation was shown. You went to school during a global pandemic. Something that hasn't been seen in over 100 years. The bravery you showed just to attend school is not going to be ignored. Your kids will learn about it. Your kids' kids will learn about it. This will be in history books. You didn't let adversity stop you from learning and participating in extracurriculars, attending school functions like prom, and literally sitting here. The biggest fear most seniors have is adapting to life after high school, such as going to college, trade school, work, or what have you. The main reason this fear exists is that your life has been the same for 12 years. You wake up, you go to school, you go to an extracurricular, job, you go home, rinse, repeat, Monday through Friday, 180 days out of the year, 12, 13 years, however long it takes you to get out of here. Some of you, hopefully not longer. But once you graduate, life comes at you fast. Different schedules, different expectations, different everything. This school year, you already accomplished all that. Every schedule, every aspect of your life was turned upside down. A few examples of how this year made your life crazies. You had to wear a mask all day, every day. You had to walk down the correct side of the hallway. You had to clean desks, sit social distance. Did I say clean desks? When school ended, you basically had to leave, go to practice, or get out. There's not really any groups. Jobs were demanding. Life in general was just difficult. You lived a jumbled up life for a long time already. There's no such thing as status quo. These past 16 months, you all adapted one way or another and accomplished what you needed to be sitting here. Every single one of you. Not because you graduated, but rather you each did it on your own terms. You did it your own way. So, congratulations. You know, after all this talking and rambling and promising everyone before that this wouldn't be too long, and the five of you graduates still paying attention, feels like math class all over again. Hey, Cheney, get off your phone. I'll give you the too long, didn't listen review. You have nothing to be afraid of because you already overcame a ton to get here. I'll leave you with one quote from my favorite children's author. Be who you are and say what you feel, because those who mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind. Dr. Seuss.
Mr. Harrison and members of the Board of Education, and all assembled here today. In accordance with section 3313.61 of the Ohio Revised Code, I, Daniel Flood, principal of Buckeye High School, hereby certify that each student assembled here as a member of the class of 2021 have met or exceeded the requirements for graduation as established by the Buckeye Board of Education. Mr. Harrison?
Thank you, Mr. Flood. I will accept your presentation of the class and note your verification that each and every individual sitting before us today has met all requirements by the Buckeye Board of Education and the Board of Education of the State of Ohio. I thank you for the job that you have done and the entire staff of Buckeye Local Schools. At this time, I make one last resolution to the Buckeye Board of Education as it relates to the class of 2021. Please accept my recommendation. Having certified that each and every individual before you today has met all requirements for graduation from Buckeye High School. At this time, I would ask that the Buckeye Board of Education come forward and accept these students and officially bestow upon them the title of graduates of Buckeye High School and present them with their diplomas. Congratulations.
We ask that you please hold applause until all names have been read. Anga Lau. Julia Ray Grady. Catherine Elaine Coons. Jaden Marie Maschak. Olivia Marie Clady. Sydney Marie Bell. Matthew Russell Baumiller. Anthony Edward Keith. John Peter Buckley. Ashby Yvette Marsh. McKenna Ann Forster. Capri Gian Thomas. Nicholas Anthony Allen. Alyssa Marie Healy. Madison Marie Ambergy. Mia Rose Anderson. Katrina Ann Andreasen. Alexis Graham Anzavino. Anthony William Ashley. Jaden Claire Asbestos. Alexa Olivia Atlasy. Sarah Michelle Bepler. Danielle Nicole Barnhart. Lucas William Bartonelli. Anna Christine Barter. Madison Nicole Bauman. Gavin Robert Beck. Alyssa Elizabeth Beckett. Austin Michael Berghaus. Abigail Rose Besida. Akina Michelle Bloom. Isabel Marie Bataro. Tobias Matthew Bracken. Christopher Andrew Brancatelli. Colin Reese Joseph Brock. Anaya Michelle Brown. Jennifer May Brown. Sean Thomas Bruner. Michael John Brunts, Jr. Emily Grace Bernheimer. McKinley Foster Butis. Zachary James Calum. Jacob Austin Kennedy. Alexander Paul Cassida. Anthony Richard Cheney. Camden Robert Shagan. Lyman Paul Chidsey. Kylie Grace Cooper. Aiden Daniel Craig. Madeline Gail Cerniak. Sophia D'Alessandro. Aiden Thomas Dalton. Chance Kaisone Davenport. Evan Sterling Davies. Andrew Joseph Davis. Reagan Matthew Davis. Alexander DeFranco. Macy Elizabeth Dendorfer. Peter Joseph Dirksen. Alexander Michael Dietrich. Matthew Christopher Dininger. Joseph Anthony Dotson. Madison Elizabeth Douglas. Amy Ann Duchesne. Natalie Brooke Duncan. William Dean Dyer. Nehemiah Nathaniel Hoagland J. Eckroth. Sarah Rose Elder. Nicholas Jalen Eric. Trinity Rain Eversole. Lindsay Nicole Fergus. Audrey Ann Figueroa. Julia Morgan Fike. Michael James Fisher. Madison K. Fermani. Samuel Thomas Gaetano. Christopher Lamont Gator.
Andrew Dakota Gideon. Kamaya Faith Gibson. Jessica Marie Girard. Logan James Graham. Sydney Lynn Graham. Tyler Joseph Greathouse. Noah William Greer. Cora Elizabeth Gunkelman. Kevin Joseph Habercorn. Trinity Ann Hannes. Brianna Faith Harshman. Karina Grace Harvey. Brooke Morgan Hayner. Benjamin Allen Herman. Zachary Allen Hill. Colin David Hubany. Natalie Marie Huber. Gavin Andrew Holvey. Alex Jonathan Hunt. Kaylin Ray Janke. Nicholas Albert Jennings. Alexia Camille Johnson. Zachary Eli Johnston. Jaden Nicholas Caroli. Courtney Diane Keeler. Kara Madison Keller. Ashlyn Rose Kelly. Russell Dylan Kemp. Olivia Renee Curlow. Hayden Kemraj Kassoon. Annabella May Cole. Joshua Matthew Kolasinski. Brandy Nicole Kravichuk. Keith Michael Krieger. Hannah Renee Cresty. Sean Edward Krasnowick.
Allison Teresa Lake. Sarah Danielle Latham. Victoria Rose Lawrence. Bryce Tanner Layton. Delaney Paige Lockard. Taylor Marie Lawrence. Caden James Luca. Sarah Catherine McPherson. Dylan Thomas Malinak. Frank Gerard Mamrak. Madeline Nicole Marquitant. Aiden Daniel Martin. Jenny Leanne Maslenka. Amanda Marie Mason. Isabella Maya Mason. Mariella Ann Mason. Michael Benjamin Mattress. Reagan Lila Hope McCourt. Gabrielle Catherine McDonald. Carrie Margaret McGilligott. River Ann McVicker. Mackenzie Brooke Mazar. Emily Renee Milkey. Brendan William Miller. Sarah Echo Goldie Miller. Griffin Lewis Mitchell. Ivan Lewis Modelinski. Nicholas Zachary Neitenbach. Zoe Jade Newell Phelps. Amaya Nicole Nutter. Caitlin Suzanne O'Brien. Alec Charles Pitek. Isabel Nicole Pimpis. Edward Charles Pince. Giovanna Isabella Petuch. Lily Noel Porta. Eden Rain Powers. Samuel James Justice Reagan. Willem Michael Justice Reagan. Honesty Nicole Marie Reed. Olivia Rose Riddler. Justin Michael Rupanovic. Morgan Olivia Seca. Kara Paige Sexton. Zachary Raymond Schell. Charlie Adam Shepherd. Ethan Paul Schrader. Autumn Lynn Sims. Brittany Lauren Smith. Hunter Bradley Smith. Lauren Noel Smith. Zachary Thomas Smuds. Zachary Richard Stapleton. Ryan Harley Steppenbacher. Sydney Rain Stevens. Stephanie Lynn Stone. Hannah Susanna Cervantes. Dylan Avery Swank. Sydney Marie Swanson. Broderick Lee Sweeney. Madeline June Taylor. Ashley Rose Tiergartner. Andrew Michael Thomas. Nicholas Brian Fakes Norris. Joshua Adam Vargo. Dylan Ventura Laureus. Riley Deem Vickerts. Catherine Helen Vote Shields. Ethan Edward Vozar. Andrew Riley Rubus. Levi Daniel Walter. Devin Alyssa Weber. Zachary Arthur Weber. Caden Michael Whitford. Briar Michael Willis. Emma Wava Wolford. Ah! Colin Alexander Wright. Malachi Terrell Wright. Natalie Grace Woods. Hannah Noelle Zur. Sierra Lily Zevchek. Chloe May Zeroni.
Okay, we do have one more speech for you, believe it or not. I have to bring up Matt Baumiller. And as Matt is coming up to the stage at this time, he is the senior class president. And as he's walking up, parents, grandparents, friends, what you don't know about Matt is every single day he ended our morning announcements with the greatest jokes ever. They did come from a book called Bad Jokes, but every single day, he would end the morning announcements that way. But the favorite thing that I could possibly tell you about Matt was about 2 or 3 weeks ago, we got the call that Matt got a scholarship. Mrs. Inman wrote up a sheet of paper, just a little note, asking Matt to read it as the last announcement. And Matt had absolutely no idea it was coming his way. Matt started to read it, and he got to the very end and realized who he was talking about. And to see the pride and joy in his face said it all. Matt Baumiller.
Sorry, everyone. days from kindergarten to senior year, we are in school for just about 6 years, which means we have been in the classroom for a third of our life. And during this time, we have all gone through a different number of experiences. Some of us have stayed in the same place. Some of us have stayed local and moved to different schools, and others of us have changed to completely different states. Personally, I have been a Buckeye Buck since preschool. And I remember in first grade seeing the year 2021, thinking it was an eternity away. And then it was sixth grade, and we were getting ready for the junior high. And then it was eighth grade, and we were scheduling for the high school. And then it was the summer of freshman year. And I was worried that I was going to have no free time, and I was going to be drowning in hours of homework. But that wasn't the case. Freshman year and high school was a time of new opportunities. The senior class has gone through a lot of changes over the years. If you look at the school itself, we've added new decorations, new accolades, and gone through an entire wave of students and staff members. At the end of our sophomore year, the athletic teams were kicked out of the Patriot Athletic Conference, and starting our junior year, we would join the Great Lakes Conference. And some of us thought that would be the end to our dominant athletic careers, but that wasn't the case. In our inaugural season, both the football team and the wrestling team won the Great Lakes Conference. And just this year, the girls' soccer team and the softball team added to that list. In mid-March of 2020, when we were sent home for an extended spring break, I didn't think we would be here right now. sitting socially distanced at Medina High School's stadium with masks. But that's just how it is. We made it work. And at the beginning of senior year, I was worried what we would end up doing. Would we be able to do anything fun? Would we have homecoming or snowball? Would we have sports at all? But we did. Even though we were supposed to be isolated from each other, I believe that this may be the rebellious teenager in us, but it brought us together. We played tag in the parking lot of the high school. We hung out at the P-Tech school, and we made student sections when we weren't allowed in the stadium. But that's how we made the best of our senior year. As class president, junior year is a time where you follow the shadow of the senior class president and see what it's like so when you're a senior, you know how to run the show. And when I followed the footsteps of Julia Conrad, I thought, this is gonna be pretty easy. It's not that bad. But it wasn't. It was far from ideal, and from the biweekly meetings with Mr. Flood, Alyssa Healy, Capri Thomas, and Kenna Forrester, we felt we were running in circles and we weren't getting anywhere. And I assured the girls that we would make it work, and I'm happy to say, given the circumstances, we made the best of our senior year. There are so many things that I love about this class, but there are two things that stick out in particular. Our sense of family and how we will never take no as an answer. At the beginning of the year, when we listed what we can and can't do, we were the ones that pushed the limits so we could make the most of our senior year. If you ask past graduates, what was the highlight of senior year, or what was the highlight of all of high school, I don't think you'd ever hear someone say, well, we made our own homecoming because we couldn't have one at school. But we did that. And our sense of family. Personally, through the cross-country team and the boys' soccer team, I can't think of other groups just like our friend groups who would sacrifice so much for a brother or sister to make sure they're okay. It is sad to say that I may never see some of you again, but all of us are on our own paths from now on. Some of us are staying local. We're going to Tri-C. Others are going as far as Arizona or Alaska for college. Others are going straight into the workforce, and then others are going into the military. But no matter what happens after today, we will all end up together, whether that's physically at a reunion or within each other's hearts. Some say it's about the journey, and others say it's about the destination. And high school is a perfect mixture of both. Some of us were just dying to get to today, and others were trying to hold on to every minute while it still lasted. And I'm proud of every one of you for all the goals you have accomplished. These goals could be as small as finishing that project that you procrastinated all week on, getting out of bed when you didn't want to go to school, or getting an A on Friday's quiz. Or they could be much, much bigger, such as picking where you're going to college, becoming valedictorian, or just leaving an impact on one person or an entire school. I love you all as a group and as individuals. I cannot imagine growing up with a better group of people. Some of you have taught me something new, such as how to be a good person, how to have fun, how to smile, and just what it takes to be a good person. So thank you. But most importantly, thank you to the Buckeye faculty. Without you guys, we wouldn't be here. So thank you, Ms. Inman, for greeting us every day with a smile. Thank you, Mr. Snook and Mr. Flood, for making the best of Buckeye. And thank you to all the teachers throughout our entire academic career who have passed on their love of a subject to us so we can grow. But most of all, thank you to those who have raised us. Thank you to mom, dad, grandparents, aunts and uncles, and guardians. You have been there through thick and thin, through the tears, through the smiles, and through the laughs. So thank you. Congratulations, graduates, on all of your accomplishments across your entire academic career. We did it. Though the days were long, the years were definitely short, but we did it. So, would the graduates please stand? And please follow me in the tradition of turning your tassel from right to left. Congratulations, Buckeye High School, class of 2021. We are officially high school graduates. Thank you, and go Bucks.
Graduates, please proceed to the tables in the back.